Righto. Well, you can probably tell me a lot more than I can tell you. So, Louis Vuitton travel trunk of very small size, all marked up here and on the clasp and the striker plates there.
It's an interesting shape. There's a pattern number and an address, and depending which address is on the locks, is depending which era it was made in.
It looks the early variant to me.
It's now one of the world's most recognisable designer brands. But back in 19th century French society, the super rich went nowhere without luggage designed by Louis Vuitton. And the trunk Drew's found seems to have its own unique history.
The small cube Louis Vuitton trunk that we've got is a real oddball piece. It is a strange size, non-standard. The interior is odd, but it is all stamped up, all the rivets are correct, and all the locks are right. What I would say is don't touch the steelwork. Leave that well alone.
Yeah.
Don't polish the brass.
No, you don't touch them.
Straps on there, and there, and there, and there. So you've got to get loads of these off.
The only drawback that you've got with these, if you take any of these studs out, I can guarantee you that all these heads are going to break off.
Really?
Yeah. So what I'll have to do with these here is very carefully take these out and hope that the spike will stay with it.
Mm. Having peeled away the fabric lining, Martin has to remove a canvas layer that's dried and cracked with age. From experience, he knows to keep an eye out for traces left behind by the original craftsman.
A lot of people used to sign underneath their work or date it. And there's been lots of times when you found messages from 100 years ago. Looks like a signature of the guy who's put it together, who is underneath the lining. If you look on that one, the signature looks very much similar. So I think this would have been the assemblyman's signature. That would have been there for 100 and odd years. And it's a little treasure to be seen, but unfortunately, once I covered it up again, it'll never be seen again.
To replace the leather straps on the trunk's exterior, Martin must delicately remove some of the precious and irreplaceable Louis Vuitton branded rivets.
You can see the heads there, and they're just bent over nails. I'm going to have to try and prise them open and lift them out so I keep them intact. It's essential when you're refurbishing something, you keep all the original parts, especially Louis Vuitton, because you can't get hold of these once they were made, and these are over 100 years old and will never be replaced. So it's essential that I try and get these out intact. I'll straighten these up and then put the new leather loop in back together with the original studs. I'm having a look at this colour. Now, in my opinion, it's not the original colour. It's been painted over the top. If you look down here on this loop, it's never come off. So when I take that leather off, we'll reveal the original colour of the case underneath.
The very first Louis Vuitton trunks, dating from the late 1850s, were light grey, soon followed by designs in beige and brown.
Look carefully, you can see the light brown canvas coming through. There we go, that is the original colour.
As this canvas layer is non-original, Martin's removing it to replace it with a colour more in keeping with when it was first built.
It looks a complete and utter mess now, but you wait for the magic to start. I'll clean the woodwork with wire wool and white spirit. It'll just take off any surface soil that it's gathered over the years. This was made in the days of coal fires, days of steam travel. So consequently, any handling that it had by porters and people was always absolutely manky.
Having stripped the cracked and peeling canvas covering, Martin has to give the trunk an authentic new outer skin. He's tracked down a modern-day fabric very close to that used by the original Louis Vuitton craftsman.
I managed to do a bit of digging, talking to people who deal in Louis Vuitton, and we came up with this material, what they call a legal buckram.
Hard-wearing buckram is made of stiff cotton and used to bind legal reference books.
It is exactly the same thickness, the same weight, the same weave, virtually the same colour as what Louis Vuitton used on their cases. So out of nothing, we've come up with a perfect replica.
It's glued on with carpet adhesive, and Martin uses a time-tested tool to achieve perfectly fitted edges.
This is what I call a bone folder. It's made of antler, which is in effect bone. It's ideal, it's smooth, it gets right into the corners that I need to crease it. But it's a piece of antler that was picked up in Scotland, and you can get right into the edges, so I know where to cut. Now that is slightly different.
After 2 weeks in Martin's workshop, this trunk is once again ready for adventure, with an elegantly aged fabric covering and lining, and retaining all the original studs and frame. Martin's even added vintage luggage labels, and the trunk is now valued at up to £3,000.
That's amazing. How have you done that?
This cloth is all new. I stripped the whole orange thing out.
Kidding.
This material is virtually the same thing the Louis Vuitton would cover their cases in the early days.
Wow. Well, there's a few things I need to ask you about it, because obviously my concern was, see these nail heads?
They're all the original.
Did you take them out?
Not all of them.
Not all of them.
The ones I took out, they all went back intact. The only things that is different are the straps itself.
I'm staggered.
And
I'm amazed.
And the outside. They're not a man of many talents,
look
you
at
see.
That! That is absolutely fantastic. I am extremely impressed with the work that's gone on there. It isn't, and by any means, perfection, and that's not what I was after. I didn't want that. I wanted it to look used, but very original. He's gone to extreme lengths to recreate the original canvas cover that was on there, but also he hasn't had to take off a lot of the ribbing that's on there. Other people will restore it in a different way. They've taken the whole thing to bits and sandblasted and done all this sort of stuff. I am not interested in that. I wanted to retain as much originality in this piece as possible and then just get the bits that were wrong back to his factory as we could. And that's exactly what he's done. Oh, wow. Look at that, and you found an original label.
Yeah. That's how they were in their heyday.
That's
I'm really chuffed.
I want to keep it. I don't want to sell it. It's got to be sold. It's got to go, but...
Oh, yeah, but it's a one-off. I don't think you'll ever see another one. I've never seen another one. 30 years, I've never seen one like it.
Magic.
It is a piece.
Thank you very much.
You're a very lucky man.
I am. Exceptional. Thank you.